What is going on, static family? So today is the first official day of the new fitment for the rear. So wow, all I can say is wow, wow and ouch, wow, because it looks so good. So okay, so the new fitment fender to lip, it looks so good, dude. Oh my god, this is insane. Like, this is an, this is the lowest I've ever been in this car. And you know what, okay, so it looks so good, but now I gotta do something about the front fitment. So like I said last night, it's either leave the rear the way it is, lower the front, or raise the rear up and just leave the front the way it is. Ah, it's a tough situation. Not really sure what I wanna do, because I really don't wanna destroy the fenders. So, for those who want to know, who have a Lexus and, you know, got questions like how I drive it, I don't know. So let's go for a drive. I actually got to go pick up some parts for Toyota, so for that the FJ in there, and let's go for a ride to see what it's like. The ride quality is the same. It is not that bad. I thought it was going to be completely bouncy, but it's fine. You guys will hear the rub, because it's a constant rub when I'm driving, which sucks. But what I'm gonna try to do is get a phone book the old method way, heat the panel up, and just drop the quarter to where I just have to pull it just a hair for it, you know, to stop the rubbing, because I'll show you guys right now what I mean. But I mean, ride quality's fine for Megan's, it's not too bad, you know. I mean, it's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Not that bad, to be honest. So I'm gonna test the phone book and see what happens with that, and see how that turns out and everything, because I don't have a fender roller right now, and I don't want to destroy it with a bat or anything like that. So, you know, I'm going to take it kind of easy with the phone book, because I just need to pull it just a hair. So, literally, that's the only reason why I'm going to pull it, because, watch, literally, it's flat road. Listen to this, too, as I start driving. Yeah. So, I'm going to have to talk kind of loud, just so you guys could hear me. But I might do it later on today. I am gonna try to do today. It's just, I gotta get that extra fingernail length just to pull it out a little bit. Just, when I turn, it's kind of fine. It's just when I'm straight. But, you know, it's just to get, you know, just, so I don't have to be dealing with this. It's so annoying. Oh my God, though, I mean, it looks so good, though. It looks like I'm on bag or something, but static for the win. Static gang. Dude, this whole COVID-19 thing is so crazy. Like, these two dealerships, Volkswagen and Nissan, went out of business. That's so crazy, dude.
All right, so I got the parts that we needed. And what do you guys think about the new Supra? Honestly, at first I didn't like them, but I must say, they are really growing on me. Like, you know, just seeing the potential of what they can, like, of what you can do with it. DDE originally, you know, they're the ones who made it, the car, like, grow on me and everything with the wide body and the crazy spoiler and everything. But damn, still a BMW though, but sick though, honestly, they're sick. You know, TJ Hunt and all them other guys, you know, who got their hands on one of these and, you know, modified them and everything. They just made them, like, it grew on me. What the hell, look, they even got carbon mirrors, that's tight. I never knew that. That is sick. What do you guys think about them though? You guys like them, you dislike them? What do you love about them? They're clean though, honestly. What do they go for? 67. That's not that bad. Compared to other new cars, I guess. Man. Hopefully somebody picks one up and does a wide body or something to it, but at the end of the day, still a BMW.
Yeah, baby, be my bubblegum. I can be so troublesome. I just wanna love you some. You don't gotta owe me none. Now I'm on the road, doing shows. That's just how it go. Taking off your clothes, let it show. Money never fold. You my rider till we die. You my angel in the sky. Blowing kisses like a blunt. Baby girl, I'm tryna stunt. You can be my number one. Won't you be my bubblegum? Yeah. Won't you be my bubblegum?
You know, it's like I said right now, it's, you know, they, I don't like them at first, honestly. I thought they were just like kind of ugly. It's just like, you know, at first I thought they were ugly. But then DDE made that wide body one. TJ Hunt got one. And you know what? Honestly, that was kind of sick, to be honest. Is it TJ Hunt? I don't know. I don't know the other YouTubers like that. Like, I think it is TJ Hunt, the one that made it orange, like the original one from, not Need for Speed, Fast and Furious. But despite the fact that, you know, my car is really nothing compared to those cars, it looks so much better with the fitment like this now. Way better. I just gotta do something about the front fitment now. Not gonna lie though, it's like, man, oh my gosh. I don't know. I'll probably just hit this with the phone book really quick, just, you know, just because I want to drive with music and everything. Because I mean, look, fitment, it's just weird. It all depends on where I'm at, because most of the spots where I'm at, the pavement's uneven. I don't know why, but technically that's the height that it's supposed to be at. Depending on where I'm at, there will be some spots where I got off the car and looked at it and the fender was, or the quarter panel was like literally on, like right on the lip. But I think that's the way it's supposed to be like this though.
Yes, that is the beautiful sound of static, man. I love it. I know a lot of you people are cringing right now, but man, I love it. That's all part of the game, baby, all part of the game. So what I'm gonna attempt to do is the old method way with the phone book. Well, not necessarily, is it a phone book? Oh yeah, it is a phone book. A phone book and a heat gun. So let's see if it works. I just wanna pull it enough a little bit just to, so I don't hear the rubbing when I drive, because it's getting really annoying. I don't wanna raise the car because I like the height. So let's give it a shot and let's see if it works. So for those who are attempting to do the same thing that I'm doing, you know, if you want to figure a way out to do, you know, something like this, you want to kind of keep a distance. Be aware that you're going to kind of get your paint like this, you know, kind of chip it up and everything if it's not really done right, or just, you know, if you apply too much heat. So what I'm doing right now is I'm kind of keeping a distance a little bit and kind of letting the powder warm up a little bit. You don't want to get too close, because if you get too close, you will burn the paint. It's happened to me on another car before. You could see the paint like starting to bubble up and everything. My friend didn't care, you know, because he saw it the same way, you know, all part of the game. But you do want to keep your distance. So let's continue to it. I'm caught in the limbo. People always gather around where the fire starts. They don't ever wanna help till we in the dark. I need to catch the tempo, give me a sec. I'm caught in the limbo. I used to sleep on a pool table, now I got tables inside by the bar. Bending our life was a cruel fable, now I realize I just live in three people. Always get close when the money comes. Hit a beat, no song. I am golden. And ladies and gentlemen, that is how you do it. As you can see right there, it's popped out, flared out. It looks so good, honestly. I mean, I just don't want it to rub. Let's see what it looks like from a distance real quick. Damn, that thing looks so good. Wow, now I just gotta do the front fitment. What's up, guys? How you guys doing? Good. They wanted to see the behind the scenes on the way I do it. And let me show them what it looks like. So basically, you guys, look at that. I'm not gonna have any rubbing issues, but right now, I'm gonna try to lower the front just a little bit. So now what we got going on, now that I got the rear all situated and everything, now I'm just gonna, I'm gonna lower the front just a tad bit, just cause you know the fitment was kind of bothering me. So I don't wanna do it too much to where I can't turn the wheel. But, oh man, that's nasty. So I'm gonna do probably lower just like a fingernail length, just, you know, a hair just to fix the fitment. So what you wanna do for other coil, for new coilover users, the bottom ring, you wanna hit it this way. In my case, you know, I have to hit it with a hammer and a flathead because I don't have the spam wrench. So you want to get right one of these, hit it, pop it to release it, and then spin this upwards and then twist the coil. So let me break it loose real quick. Before anything, I forgot to do, so everybody measures their height different. The way I do it, it's gonna be hard with this tape measure because it doesn't have the little lock thing. Let me try to get in there. So basically the way I'll measure the height, not the height, the exact height, but the way, whichever way I twisted it, I'll basically get the bottom of the tape measure and just measure it to the top of the top ring. So from the bottom to the top ring, it looks like it's about, 3.5 inches. Let me try to eyeball it more. Yeah, about 3.5 inches, just in case I go too low. That's where I'm gonna know where to raise it back up.
I got another gang story to tell, Pete, about how a black nigga was born in hell. And right then and there, it's no hope, cause a nigga can't escape the gangs and the dope. Damn, and when it's black on black, that makes it shitty. Can't survive in the Compton.
Alright, so let's see what it looks like real quick, and then if I like the way it looks, I'll copy the other side. So now, the passenger side, I'm just gonna copy the same measurements, and well, that's it, I'm done with the fitment. So let's get to it.
But I'm young, so nobody would wonder that the hood would take me young. Always strapping, even if you let me out. I'm a few ages older, got hair on my nuts and I'm a little bit bolder, and putting in work, I have to do my fucking part. I'm down for the hood and it's planted in the heart. Fool, at school slapping on the girls' asses, fuck the white education, so I skip a lot of classes, cause ain't no teaching a nigga white reality. Teach me the motherfucking gang mentality. Pop, 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 drops the sucker. If he's from another hood, I got to shoot the motherfucker. Gee, I'm in it to win it and can't quit. Fool and ready to die for this shit.
Alright guys, so this is the passenger side. I don't know, it looks a little bit different from the driver's side. But you know what, whatever, stop. That's exhaust, don't worry about it. All right, so now we did this side, let's check this side on the clearance. It's real! All right, turn the wheel to the right. Go. Go, 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 go. Perfect, go all the way to the left. Go, go, go. All right, now back up to the right. Is that it? Keep going. Go left. Straighten it up. Let's go double check the other side really quick. All right. Turn it to the left. All the way to the right. And we're golden. Let's go. Oh my God! Is that a big difference? Wow. All adjusted, you guys. So. I hope these tips really help you guys out for, you know, those who really don't have a lot of material on, and you guys are limited on what you got to for tools and everything, is what I'm trying to say. But meanwhile, with this high, I will be taking it low and slow, no more, at least in the meantime, you know, until I raise it up and everything. But damn. Ah, I forgot how bouncy it is. That's a first, man. I'm never really low on gas. Oh, shoot. I'm never low on gas. That's a first. I barely have the check, not the check engine, the gas light on. Damn, buddy, slow down. You're in a daily. Slow down, my man. Sheesh. So let's get another quick shot of the fitment. That way you guys, I mean, let me see if I can get close enough so you guys can see how much clearance I have. So as long as you roll the fender properly and you roll it enough, all fender, you know, two front fenders and the quarters and everything, you guys will be completely fine. Just make sure you do it properly. Make sure you apply like the right amount of heat to it and everything, and you will honestly be completely fine. But yeah, this is the way it looks. Let's look at the back right now. I'm gonna do another walk around just so you guys can see how it looks, and you know, kind of from like eyeball level. That way you can see how the fender, not the fender, the fitment is. Let me do a quick walk around.
Yo, Wallace, I can't get you on my mind. Everything about you, girl, just be so damn divine. And I bet you know that you the Bonnie to my Clyde. Hop up in my rapper, start the highway with my bride. Be my Mia Wallace, I can't get you on my mind. Everything about you, girl, just be so damn divine. And I bet you know that you the Bonnie to my Clyde. Hop up in my rapper, start the highway with my bride. She got the white see-through dress. Could give a fuck about my ex, I'm flexing check after check. These niggas know that I'm a mech. She worked them late hour shift. After nine, she hit the spliff. Her name is Tiff. Yeah, she high.
I really hope you guys enjoy these videos, and you know, like I said, if you guys want to see some different content in the videos, comment down below or hit me in the DM, whichever one. That way I can get back to you guys on what you guys want to watch. More car, you know, for the next couple of videos, more car content, more paint content, you know, cruises or something. Let me know what you guys want to see, and I promise I'll get to you guys on that. But anyways, you guys know what to do. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. My name is Robert again, for those who don't know me, and this is Static Living. See you guys on the next vlog. Peace.